Good evening, everyone. Hope all of you are doing well. Please share this link along with your friends, all FMGs who already graduated and who are studying. Today live is on student demand because there are many things, many up and down in last 4 or 5 days, or we can call in last week. So today the main reason of coming online suddenly,
because students are like calling
us. Yeah, students are calling us and they are messaging us. They are asking, sir, please come online and just please tell the reality what is going behind the scene.
There are many letters, so many newspapers.
So all dear students, kindly share this Facebook link on your timeline. Kindly share the link among your friends in WhatsApp and Instagram, okay, and WeChat, okay. So just we'll wait for 2-3 minutes and then we'll start.
Start, yeah. Yeah, we'll just discuss all the things regarding Karnataka, regarding other states. We'll discuss all the things. That's why we came online. So kindly join the link. Please just forward this FB live link to your friends, your batchmates, because like many students are calling us and they're messaging us. They want to know the clarity. They want the clarity on all these things going on. The students, those who are going to attend this FMG 18th June, or many students, those who will like those who are studying in either fourth year, fifth year, first year, second year, third year, they are also worried about that NMC draft. Many Telegram things is also, many like campaign is also going on just like Twitter. So we'll discuss all the things. We'll discuss the strategies and we'll discuss the student, because the students from last 2 days they're not able to concentrate on studies as well. So we'll discuss each and everything. Please share the link as much as possible and we'll just start in another 2 minutes, okay?
Yeah, dear, as you can see our all the updated points on which we are gonna talk. So don't worry, just wait for 2-3 minutes. Once we'll start, we discuss all the points and we will also take your questions. So don't worry, we are with you here, and this live conversation will be there for 30-40 minutes. So if you have any question regarding even draft and anything, we are gonna answer each and everything.
Is there any update about FMGs working on COVID duty? Yeah, dear, like we'll discuss each and every point. Just wait for another 1 minute and we'll starting it. need to continue to fight for, right? Indian also does not want anyone to manage.
Okay, so I think we should start. Good evening, everyone. Sabko namaskar. I hope all of you along with your family members are doing well. All your health, everyone at your home are safe, okay, and healthy. So see, the main reason why we came like online today in very short notice, because there are so many messages we are getting from last two, three days. Because there are so many like letters, and there are so many things like news and all, which are just getting viral in all WhatsApp, Telegram groups, and we are getting so many messages and call.
Are you audible
to all of you? If there is any voice problem, please let us know. Okay, so I think we are audible to everyone. Okay, guys. So see, the main important thing which all of us want to know, and all of you should know, that the current situation of India is very worst. We are currently facing wave 2 of COVID-19, and there are many cities in India like Delhi, Mumbai, Maharashtra, many states, they are badly affected with this COVID-19. And believe me, guys, many cities in India are now becoming graveyard. Okay. Yeah. And the situation is really, really, really bad. Okay. So regarding that, today there is an update from Prime Minister office that they have.
Secretary level meeting yesterday,
yeah,
regarding the manpower. Okay.
Yeah.
And like, as we have given the letter, everybody like want to push them to take the SMGs and all the things. But the information which we got from that so-called meeting was that the health ministry is not at all giving the data of foreign medical graduates to PMO. Means actually, like, the process is like in all the situation, the process is like that the things go from a proper channel. And for doing all this thing, for getting the things, the proper channel is, it should go from the health ministry to the PMO. Then the PMO needs to take the
initiative. Further,
or take the initiative. But the update we got yesterday only, we got it, but we were waiting that might be today they might have do something good for FMG. But yesterday only we got that information that they have not given any data of FMGs. And they have not talked about anything regarding FMG in that meeting. That is why PMO has not taken any decision in favor of FMG.
Yeah.
That is not mentioned. Even they mentioned the BSc and the nursing staff and all the stuff they've mentioned, but they have not mentioned the FMG. Okay, because there are two, three different reasons why they're not mentioning it. Because if we'll talk about, like, many students are messaging us, and that they are saying that they are taking BHMS, they are taking BMS, they are taking dentist, they are taking nursing staff, but why they are not taking FMGs? So the main reason is that these people, they are taking just for the time period, just for the corona time. Okay, so they are not giving anyone license to practice allopathy full life for the rest of their life. But what we are asking them, we are not asking to just do the job for 2 or 3 months. You guys are not just want to do the job for 2 or 3 months. Everybody here wants to get rid of this FMG examination, and they want to give 1 year free services to the government in this hard COVID situation. So that is the thing what we are asking from them. And basically, they are not ready right now to give that's why, like, they have not decided on such things, on such clause, to give the permanent license or the permanent registration to the foreign medical graduates without licensing exam, clearing FMG examination. That is why they have not mentioned our point, and they have not raised our thing in front of PMO. So that's why today, in that full that release which was given by PMO,
press release
regarding the manpower, FMG was not mentioned. So I guess you guys have got the point why FMG was not mentioned, even though nursing staff was mentioned over there, because these people are not in the race of getting the permanent registration. You got that point, because we want the permanent registration from them. So that is the thing. And secondly, like many students, like yesterday there was a meeting, actually we have written a letter on 15th of March to all the chief ministers and all the health ministers, 15th of April to all the chief ministers and all the health ministers of India regarding this issue, and we want them to just allow FMGs to work and to give the provisional registration to them so that they can work free of cost for the 1 year, and after that when they'll complete it they can get the permanent registration. So like on various good personalities and well-known personalities of India also raising this issue. I'm very thankful to all the organization as well, like those who are raising this issues. IMA also have raised this issue that FMG should be involved in this war and all this thing. So finally, yesterday we got that news that Karnataka government have accepted that they'll take the foreign medical graduate without FMG examination. So that was the news which was circulated all over the media. We also got that news. That's why we've just sent it to all of you, and we said that we'll get the confirmation from the concerned bodies. We are in talking to them, and whenever we'll get the confirmation, we'll get back to you. So today or like yesterday also we've tried to talk to Rajistar, but yesterday was a holiday. Today we have sent around 20-25 students to Karnataka Medical Council regarding all the registration and all the things. So what happened exactly is that the people of the medical that council, Karnataka Medical Council, they said that we have not got any letter from the government. They have not received any letter regarding that from the government. So they said that either you guys have to wait for that, because they are also aware of that news. They have the students just showed them the newspaper and everything. So they said, okay, that news is there. They also heard about it, but they have not any official paper for that. They don't have any official paper to register foreign medical graduate students on the basis of just like with that degree without FMG. So they said you need to wait for that. So full day the students were there and they were waiting, and still there is no official paper which come out from the Karnataka government or from Karnataka Health and Family Welfare or Karnataka Medical Council have not received any letter regarding that thing. So just keep this thing in your mind, that because many students they were asking, sir, Karnataka have given the permission, what about others? So that is the thing. Let us wait for the Karnataka health ministries that letter. We are also talking to various governments, like we are talking to Delhi government, Maharashtra government also, are people are talking, somebody is talking to Jharkhand government, Gujarat government also. So we are talking to 3-5 governments regarding the same. We want them to allow FMG, not temporary. We are not seeking a temporary job for all of you people for 2 or 3 months or 4 months or 5 months. We are seeking for the permanent registration for you guys. Okay, so that is the thing what we are seeking for. And that is how you are differentiated from the GNM, from the BHMS, from the BMS, and from the BDS. So that is the differentiate between you and them. Some of the students have said that now Italy medical staff and they are also coming to India, and their government of India is also taking their help and all the things. So I just want to clear, they are coming here to help. They are not coming here to take the permanent registration. You guys, I guess now you got the point. What is the differentiation and why government need to think a lot? Why they need to think a lot for FMGs? Because we are seeking for the permanent registration from them after completion of our provisional 1 year internship or like this. So that is the difference, and that is why they are taking a lot of time. And I guess like most of the funda is clear to with all of you regarding today's PM, that press release of PMO regarding the that manpower which needs to be increased, and regarding that Karnataka Medical Council as well. So we are awaiting for the final official paper from them, and we are still working. I just talked to PMO twice, and they told me that our letter is already with them. but they need to take that decision with the help of the ministry, with the help of the health ministry and all the things, because they have protocols to follow. So we are trying all our level best with the thing. But what we want to guide you, at least just for the students, those who are just preparing for the 18th June examination, for all such students, we just want to tell you that just all these things keeps apart. Just concentrate on your studies, at least till right now. Whatever things needs to do, we are doing it. Okay, so don't worry about it. Whatever, if we'll require you, will we need anything from your side, we will let you know. Guys, like right now, after completing this, we'll take your questions as well. Don't worry. So whatever will require from you, we'll let you know as well. So just be stick on your preparation. And like many students are also having the doubt regarding that the postponement of the examination. So for right now, like for PG examination and DNPI examination is postponed because these students are working right now as a like GR or as a intern in the medical hospital. And then if this 180,000 students will go for the examination, that will affect the whole medical system of India. So that's why Government of India have decided to postpone the NEET PG examination as well as DNB examination. Okay. So that is why their exam is postponed. But if the situation will get better in the month of June, I guess, so they'll definitely take our exam and we'll get to know, because nobody can predict about the COVID. COVID is the thing which we cannot predict anything. So we need to wait for this, because many students are asking, sir, what about the postponed examination, whether it will get postponed or not. So just wait, just forget everything, forget each and everything, and just keep this thing in your mind that you are having examination on 18th of June. So prepare accordingly. If something will come to our way, definitely we'll share it with you. And don't worry, if we are not asking you to do anything, it doesn't mean that we are not doing the things. Whatever we can do from last 2-3 days, 4 days, we are just trying to meet the officials, we are just trying to call the officials, and we are doing the things on our part. So you just wait for whatever the things will come. But at least those who are appearing in June, please prepare and don't get deviate. Okay. And after that, like Armandeep will also talk, and we'll talk on NMC draft as well, and we'll take your queries as well. So yeah,
Armandeep. Yeah. Guys, see, I am feeling very bad, because if I was the health minister of India, I will surely add you people in this COVID-19 fight, because India is in very bad situation right now. Might be they can increase the beds, might be they can increase the number of oxygen cylinders, might be they will increase the number of ventilators, but from where they will cover up the ratio of doctor and patient. You know, in India, the ratio between doctor and patient is not that good. Okay. So the important thing, what I am feeling bad, that I don't know, it is just a simple initiative. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare can come in front and they can have a press conference and they can tell that, yes, we are having more than 40,000-50,000 foreign medical doctors who have graduated from the top universities of World Health Organization. We can add all those people in the system. But I don't know why they are missing this thing. Might be they are in some dilemma, or I don't know what they are doing. But exactly, you guys are not here to risk your life just for the sake of 1 year registration. Believe me, we will only make you people do COVID duty if the government will say, yes, we are ready to give one-time exemption to all of you, or we will give you any relaxation or grace marks. Because maybe because for government, your life is not important, but for all of us and for your family, your life is very important. So remember one thing, all those people who are feeling from 2 days that might be we are not good for anything, nobody is talking for us, why we are not able to serve the nation, we have already a degree of MBBS or MD physician. Guys, chill up. It is not the end of your life. You have a long, long, long life to live and to serve your country, to serve your people. But we will not risk your life for the sake of 1 year COVID duty. We will only negotiate with the government if they want to talk on this, that if they are ready to provide one-time exemption, or they will give some relaxation, either in a way of reduction of percentage or in a way of giving any grace marks. So please, all those students who are texting me from 2-3 days that, sir, why it is happening to us? Why they are not involving us? Guys, might be God wants to give you something better. So don't give up at this time. Yeah, and see, I'll tell you, yesterday also and today also, Neeraj bhai, along with our team, we are trying to have a conversation in Prime Minister office and we are doing it. But the main thing is that PMO won't do anything. They need a proper guideline. They need a proper instruction from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Once the report is given to PMO, then only PMO will take any decision, because it is a matter of health. So directly, indirectly, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is involved. It is a very logical thing. You all have to understand, guys. Okay. So the thing is very important, which you need to know, that it is not the end of your life. You guys want to serve the nation, and I want that all FMG will serve the motherland. But the point is that you all will get opportunity, but just wait. Might be God wants to give you something great and something bigger. So don't get upset, because I am getting continuous messages of students, sir, why they are not involving us? Do we have some problem? No, guys, you don't have any problem. The main issue is this, that I don't know why ministry is so much careless for this thing. The situation is very bad. States like Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Delhi, all are becoming graveyard. There are so many deaths every day. There are more than 500 plus people are dying here in Delhi. Delhi is the city and it is the capital of India. And even people are dying. There is no bed somewhere. There is no oxygen. We can observe this very closely because we are just staying hardly 500 meters or 1 kilometer away from AIIMS and Safdarjung. And this too, and the same situation is all over India, guys. So please, this is my message to all my younger brothers and sisters. Please, guys, don't deviate yourself, because I'm getting the messages and I have texted 3-4 people personally. Beta, don't deviate yourself. When the time then MFPB 30 was going, that time also, I was always saying, don't stop your studies. Because once you stop your studies, things will get worse. Because if you study, if something good happen, it's very good. The knowledge remains with you. This same knowledge you can use for your PG or for future. But the current situation is this. There is no official notification and any relaxation for FMGs. Yes, there are so many associations. There are IFMS, MCI Gurukul Trust, there are Neeraj Bhaiya, Arman Bhaiya, and there are so many unseen people who are helping all of us.
Even though like today, one of the member of NMC has also
yeah, he is registrar of Bihar Medical Council. So guys, and it is very clear, guys. हम लोग बेगानी शादी में अब्दुल्ला दीवाना नहीं है. वी आर नॉट के भाई किसी के भी घर पे शादी हुई हमें कार्ड नहीं दिया हम चले जाएंगे. नो, वी आर वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट पीपल. माइट बी यू आर नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर सेल्फ, बट यू आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मी, यू आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर पेरेंट्स, एंड यू आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर सोसाइटी. सो ऐसा नहीं है, कोविड में मरने के लिए ऐसे थोड़ी भेजेंगे यार. देयर शुड बी अ प्रॉपर चैनल. गवर्नमेंट शुड गिव अस अ प्रॉपर thing in return, that if they are taking this 20,000 foreign medical doctors, then it is just not for 1 year. Because you are a doctor, you are not a tissue paper that we just use for 1 year. COVID is gone. Okay, now you are also gone. We don't want this thing with you guys, you know.
Why BSc, why BHMS, why GMS? Because these all are temporary. They are not, government is not providing them full life to practice allopathy.
I'll tell you, like, I will tell you in a very simple word, you will understand it very, because you all are foreign medical doctors and you are very educated. It's like the commitment or relationship which PMO or Prime Minister office is making with BSc people or BHMS people or dentists or with nurses is not a permanent relationship. It's just a casual relationship. Okay. 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 6 month, 1 year, and then break
you
up.
You must have seen that in that policy they've mentioned that national health mission.
If someone will do service for 100 days, they will get some PMO certificate. But guys, it is very good. But we don't want just that certificate. We want a permanent registration for all of you for lifetime.
You want to serve country all of your life, na?
because you guys are going to risk your life, and I know you are so much desperate to
work.
I know every day, every minute, I am getting hundred and hundred of messages.
It's like soldiers are waiting
to go
enter into the war.
Yeah,
but they are not allowed to go there. So
yeah,
you people are feeling like that.
I know.
But we don't want you to go just for a 1 month, 2 month, 3 month tenure, and the things will
so guys please, it is my message to all foreign medical doctors fraternity, please don't feel low that you are good for nothing. You are everything. We don't want any 6 months or 1 year relationship with this thing. We want a permanent registration for you people. If government is going to give that, we will appreciate and we will welcome. Day before yesterday, I had a talk with Delhi government health secretary, and I told him that, sir, there are more than 20,000-30,000 MBBS doctors can get available if you allow me to do it. Then he was asking me, do they have Delhi Medical Council registration? I was shocked. I was like, sir, agar unke paas DMC hoti to why should I ask you? They are already, agar unke paas DMC hoti to wo already, they are working, right? They don't have DMC. They are stuck with this exam. If you want their services, please make any guideline. Unko one time exemption do, or reduce their percentage, or reduce, give some relaxation or grace marks. But we want the permanent solution. We don't want that the foreign medical doctors are treated like a tissue paper or like a temporary girlfriend. Ke bhai 6 mahine 1 saal relationship chalega jab tak covid khatam nahi hota. Jis din covid khatam hua, bhai tum ghum jana, hum laat maar denge. No. If it is going to happen, I will not let this happen to any one of you. Okay, so please note it down in a very clear word. One more important thing which Neeraj bhaiya already defined, and I am going to tell again. Karnataka Medical Council, there was some news that Karnataka government, Yedurappa ji, the chief minister of Karnataka, has decided that now FMGs also work for the COVID. But guys, I am in a contact with the registrar of Karnataka Medical Council. He has not confirmed me anything till now. Today there is a team of more than 30 foreign medical doctors were sent to, by us to KMC, but they are not replying on this thing. They are telling that we haven't got any official notice by government. Okay, so guys, no, always FMGs alone. No, Deepak bhai, FMGs are not alone. We are with you people. If you are alone, then why the hell we are here? Why we always come and talk for you people? You are not alone. We all are one family. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm telling again and again. Please don't think that you are alone. We are one family. But this time the situation is very worse. We will only tell you people to go for work if government is going to negotiate for something permanent option.
We want the permanent or the provisional registration for you to do the internship, and after completion of that, we want the permanent registration. Okay.
We need now a permanent solution. We don't need just a 6 months or 1 year relationship. That is the most important thing. So don't feel bad. Okay.
Yeah. Now let's talk about the NMC draft. Like many of the students, those who are in like 5 years, fifth year, sixth year, or first, second, third, fourth year. Like they are also messaging here of regarding all the things. I guess you guys have already got one letter, draft. We have made one reply letter for the draft, and we've give some comments regarding all the points which was mentioned in that draft. And I guess thousands of students have already emailed it to the given email IDs.
Yeah, and Hindustan Times, ANI, and all.
Everybody has covered. Also covered
Times
that.
Of India.
Times of India. Everybody's covered that news as well. And many Twitter campaign is also going on. So I just want to just request you one thing. Twitter is a good thing. It is always a good thing. Like there is like per day 30-40 points are trending, and then it will go down. It will go up. It will go down. But when you send the mail to someone, it is directly going on their email. So it's a thing which is affecting them directly. You got my point. So I want all the students, like we'll just give all the details, all the students regarding that NMC draft. I'm not talking with the students who are appearing in this June examination. You guys just sit and just study for your examination. Whenever we'll require anything from you guys, we'll let you know. By the time, just study well, okay? And as we have a free test series for all the foreign medical graduate, you can download the app. You can have the free test over there and the free study material over there. Okay. And regarding all the people who are not appearing in this June examination, please, we'll just send you the details. We want maximum number of email should be reached to the health ministry, should be the reached to the NMC, to the concerned people, so that they should know, they should aware that, okay, we have made the draft and it is affecting almost 40, 50, 60,000 right now. What if we'll take the action? If we'll take the action, then it will be a negative thing for us. So they, it should be like this. So please keep emailing them regarding the draft, to change the draft, to just show your comments. You can just run that Twitter campaign and all the thing. That is a separate thing. But at the same time, please keep emailing them, because email is a thing which will go directly into their email box, and directly it is shown. Twitter, if you are just tweeting something, it's a good thing, but it is not affecting them. But if you send something in their email ID, it is directly affecting them. They are able to see that, okay, thousands were regarding the one thing, okay, everybody, every student is concerned about it, so they'll take action on it. Okay. And one more thing, as like we and our team, as we've just told you last time, that now IFMS Welfare MCA Gurukul Trust is not alone. We have made a organization, association of all the consultants of India or from all part of India, and it is IAFMEC, Indian Association of Foreign Medical Education Consultants. So they are also behind all this thing, and they are also working for
more than more than 500 plus educational consultants of India are with you, and they all are working, and they all are using, yeah,
everybody is using their contacts and
their personal
and
contact. Yeah,
we just want
so guys you guys are not alone. All educational consultancy, fraternity, everyone is with you. Okay, you are not alone at all.
We are seeking regarding this NMC draft, and we are seeking for the appointment as well.
Yeah,
soon.
Yeah.
Like, I guess within a week or 10 days at most, will meet the officials directly.
Yeah.
And because it's a very high COVID situation in Delhi, so people are just not giving the time. They are saying it's a corona situation, we cannot meet anyone, this is not the right time to meet. But we are trying our level best, and hope we'll meet the officials within 7 to 10 days. And we are trying to sort out this problem as soon as possible. So don't worry, all the students, those who are in tension or in dilemma about this draft, whether it will be 2 attempt only, that 10-year things, just forgetting each and everything. It will be same as usual, what is right now going on. Don't worry for that. The rules will remain the same. And we want the rules of NXT for foreign medical graduates should be like Indian medical graduates. So we are working for it only.
We want one nation, one exam. There should be no separate exam for FMGs. There should be no 2-year foundation. There is no compulsion of 10 years, and there is no compulsion of anything. The rules remain the same, and it was clearly mentioned in NMC Act that all the rules and regulation will be same for all. Okay. So guys, regarding NXT, this draft, the update is that very soon we are meeting the officials in NMC, okay, and we will sort out this problem. So don't worry for this. There will be no 2 attempts. There should be not at all possibility that they will keep it same. We were gonna change it, and they will be unlimited. Okay, so don't worry for that.
As we are getting the messages of students that April 30 is the last date, I'll tell you, like, on I guess 18th of April, we came online, we sent messages to all the students, and I asked students to fill the Google form so that I have the details, how many students wants to appear for these upcoming SMGs, those who are getting their final result after this 30th April. And I've sent it to all the students, I've asked them to fill the form. Hardly, I guess 5 to 6 thousand students are there, but hardly I got only 212 forms. So that is the insincerity of the students. If I want anything from NB, if I want NB to change anything, we should have numbers in our hand. Hardly 212 students fill the form. How can I ask NB to change the date on the basis of this 200 students only? I know there are 4,000 to 5,000 minimum students, those who want to give the examination, but they are not at all serious for themselves. I asked everyone to fill the form, to fill the form, to fill the form, but I got only 212 forms. So that is the problem. The second problem is that on that day only, like in New Delhi, that lockdown started, and the all the offices, government offices, they are working with the less staff. They are not allowing outer person to come without appointment, and when you are calling them, they are not giving proper appointment.
Piyush bhai, see, they are treating us like we don't belong to this country, incredible India. See, Piyush bhai, I already told you that we will gonna put our life in danger, and we are ready. I know each and every FMG is ready to give their life for the India, for the motherland, but we need a surety from government of India and from the state government. See, we can't be used like a tissue paper, that they will use us for 6 months or 1 year and then they will throw us. No guy, no bro, it's not possible. If they want us to serve, we are ready to serve, but there are some things which they need to give. They have to give one time relaxation, or they have to give some exemption, or they have to give any grace marks or something like that. So if something gonna happen, just happily go and work. And if it is nothing, and if it is not happening, don't feel hopeless, because it is not the end of your life. Why FMGs are getting depressed so fast, guys? You are a motivated people. You have studied 6 years in abroad and you have seen everything. You are very matured. Why you guys suddenly got hopeless? I don't like this. Be a champion. Be like a king. Be like a lion. Don't be like hopeless. Yaar, hamari to koi sun nahi raha. Hum to bahut gareeb hain. Hamare sath to bahut bura ho raha. Hamare sath bada atyachar. Arey, stop it, yaar. You guys are champion. You guys are proud of your family. You guys are proud of ourselves. Don't compare yourself with
them. They are doing their work, and their work is different. Government is allowing them because they have not restriction with them. But with us, they need to give us the permanent or provisional registration. That is the problem. Okay. And don't put any political comments over there.
I think everything is clear to you guys. So now the point is that there is no official announcement. If anything announced, we will come and we will inform you as soon as possible.
Students are appearing on 18 June. Please
prepare. Continue your studies. Please continue your studies.
Thing that as if the situation will remain good, then definitely they'll take your paper. Okay. And regarding provisional, also I told you, yeah. Just if you have completed your degree final examination before 30th April, and if your result is declared, then you are eligible to fill the form. And if it is a plus minus 14-15 days, like situation is with you, and if you can take the risk of 6,000-7,000, then I'll just tell you to take that risk as well, because might be like because right now the situation is going on, might be they'll allow you as well. Might be.
See, my suggestion is very clear.
If you are getting the degree on 15th of April, your result is declaring on 10th of May or 15th of May. If there's a thing of 10, 15, 20 days, then take a chance if you can afford.
Yeah.
If it is feasible for you, then I'll suggest you to take the chance and fill the form.
See, you have invested 20-25 lakh on MBBS. If you feel that investing 7,000 is okay, I'm not telling you that might be they will accept, might be they will reject also, but you can take a risk of 7,000. It's not a very big amount. If you can afford, guys, okay, if you can afford, it is my suggestion to everyone to fill the form. Okay, if you are not able to afford, and if you are not coming at that eligibility criteria till today, don't fill the form. That is the thing. So thank you very much, all of you. Be safe, be healthy, and take care of your mother and father and all the people, all the relatives who are having different diseases. Okay, especially take care of your like dada dadi and everyone. Okay, jinko bhi diabetes ho, hypertension ho, family mein aise rishtedar maa baap agar hain, to please unki special care karo beta. Duniya ki seva karne ke liye pura zindagi baki hai. Abhi filhal apni health ka dhyan rakho aur apne maa baap ki, apne rishtedaron ki सेवा करो. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. थैंक यू वेरी
मच. एग्जामिनेशन इज डन विद 28th ऑफ अप्रैल. रिजल्ट इज नॉट डिक्लेयर्ड. टेक्निकली अकॉर्डिंग टू द लाइक द डेट व्हिच इज गिवन इन द एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया, यू आर नॉट फिट इन दैट क्राइटेरिया. बट इफ यू कैन टेक द रिस्क, आई विल बेटर सजेस्ट यू टू टेक दैट रिस्क एंड फिल द फॉर्म. ओके, And if you are getting the degree, I as I told you, if 15, 20 days the thing is there, please take the risk. If you can afford that. Declared on May 6th, that's the problem from our university. If it is, it will appear, it will declare on 6th May as well. It will appear on 6th May as well. Then you can fill the form. Any postponed, right now we cannot tell the things. If the things will be under control in June itself, they'll take the examination. The problem with DNB and PG was different because these doctors are working right now in the hospitals and they don't want to want them to go 1 or 2 days away from their posting. So that is why they just postpone these two examinations. But with R, they might not take this action. If the situation will be good, they'll take your examination. Any good, any other question if you want to ask? If you have any other query, just then. If getting degrees in July, then better to prepare for the next FMG. That will be in December, hope so. So it's better because in July, and if you are like many students from Philippines, those who are getting degree in July, you guys are not having provisional with you. You are not have done with your final examination. So because for that, at least those students who are getting provisional, those can get provisional by or provisional or the main degree by 15th May or 30th May, they can try by their own. State is not allowed to do remaining internship. Even advisory came on NMC. Are you talking about the students who have cleared MCI or those who have not FMG or those who have not cleared FMG? Mohammed. Yeah, regarding incomplete internship, you have completed, you have cleared FMG or not? Vartika, you have completed or not? Don't worry. If you have taken the transfer in the past, don't worry. We won't let any bad thing happen to you guys. But if you want to take in future, those students, those who are in third, fourth, fifth year, please let us know before taking. We'll just guide you whether you need to take or not. No. If you'll fill the form and they'll either they'll accept you or they'll reject you. They will not take any illegal action against you because you're not doing anything illegal. No? Did you try in Punjab Medical Council? The thing is that Punjab is following Delhi. Punjab, okay. Yeah, Arman bhai talked in Punjab Medical Council regarding that as well. We are talking to the various registrar regarding this. Within my 10th, we can submit it on 15th. I just checked that brochure. Like the last date of giving your provisional degrees, I guess 6th of June. I guess like you might, I think you should check it again. But if you're getting it on 15th and if you have done with your examination and if you want to take the risk, you can. Whether they can consider FMGs in upcoming days. Yeah, the thing is that this question, we are fighting for this from last almost, it's been 10 months till now. 10 months for that this thing and internship and all the things started from 12 months before, so we can try that. The thing is that we only what we have in our hand is to just put our efforts. The result isn't not in our hand, it's in God's hand or to the official's hands. So I cannot comment on them. I can try my level best, and that's what we are trying right now. Rajasthan also. Yeah, like few people, those who are having contact with the health ministers or the chief ministers of your states, just WhatsApp me on my number 8878762767. I'll just provide you the letter regarding this and you can give it to your health ministry or your chief minister to serve it, because I have already given it. But if being the local person of that state, it would be definitely good if you give it by yourself or through your some of your known or sources like this. Yeah, the problem is that the advisory, like few of the states, they have accepted that advisory. That advisory is not at all related to FMGs. That advisory was related to IMGs only. But somehow some of the states have accepted that advisory and they've allowed the students to do internship, remaining internship from India. But some students, some states are not allowing right now. They are awaiting for the NMC confirmation. So I'll suggest you one very good thing. Better to file one RTI. If your state council have given one letter to NMC, and they are asking that we didn't get the final reply of that. Just ask that letter copy from your state medical council and just put it on RTI. And if you're not able to put, just share it to me. I'll help you out for this. So they have to answer within 1 month. So if your state medical council is telling you that we have asked to the NMC, but they are not replied, they have not replied till now to us. So then please WhatsApp me. I'll just help you out how to get rid of this problem within 1 month. Yeah, anything else you want to know? Because many people are having many different queries. So that's why we've decided to come online and solve all your queries at one time only. So any more queries we have? Telangana Medical Council. We are trying to contact the medical councils from our end, the registrar and all. If you have your contact, then you can let us know. We'll give the letters to you. You can just forward it to them. So I guess like you guys have done with all the question answers of today. So just as me and Arman Bia, Dr. Arman have told you, those students who are appearing in this examination, I just want to conclude, please concentrate on your examination. And if something will good come to you, we'll let you know. Don't get deviate or distract. We'll let you know. And if we need anything from you, we'll let you know. Okay. Means anything want from you to do, then we'll let you know what to do. We are getting in June, July, is then possible for them. Decision of it possible, then yeah, actually newspaper, news channels are covering. Genius also showed that the foreign medical graduates are there. 20,000 medical graduates are there. Aaj Tak also showed the same news. But totally depend upon the, you must say that the medical, the health ministry, they have to take a proper action. They need to forward it a proper way to PMO. Then only the things can be done. That's what we are trying to anyone. No. NMC isn't replying to anyone of RTI file. If it is there, just do one thing. WhatsApp me with your RTI. Vartika, just WhatsApp me with your RTI. I'll just help you out if anyone of you have filed the RTI. Because there's a 1 month time you need to reply in 1 month time only. Okay. If you're, they might have not replied the letter of your that state council. But for the RTI, they need to reply within 1 month. Within 30 minutes, 30 days of time. That's why I told you, if you're getting degree in May, if you have done with your examination, if you the result is declared or not declared, if your result is declared before 30th, you are in that thing that you can fill the form, your eligibility criteria is fulfilled. But if not got that, please kindly wait, or you can take the chance, then you can go for it. Thank you, Shubham. Yeah, Neil is also doing very good today. Also, like Times of India news was there, which like Neil was in Gujarat. Yeah, actually, our all team, like full IFMS Gurukul team, is working together, and it is working like all the members of IFMS. They are 24/7. They are thinking how to help each other and how to do the things. So everybody is doing very good. Regarding draft, as we told you that please will share the details. Kindly keep mailing to the officials, and soon we are going to meet the officials. But we want them to be in pressure. If we'll keep sending the emails, then definitely it will create pressure on them. Provisional is compulsory to apply for F. No, if you'll get the provisional by 6th of June, and if your result is declared, you just properly read that information brochure. So you'll get all the details over there. And if you have any confusion regarding that, then you can text me. Okay. So I guess we've completed all the points, and we've concluded all the things. So regarding conversation. Yeah, the thing is that they have put the things on the everything was providing by the NMC only, and everything by MCA only. And now the reason behind pushing the FMGs as well, because they want maximum student to study in the BHMS, BMS or the BDS courses. They not want you to join MBBS courses if you cannot afford 70, 80 lakhs of fees. That is something is going on, and that is the thing which is pushing from the back end from someone. So I guess, yeah, we have done with the meeting. We have talked a lot regarding all the issues, and I guess all of your issues are solved. So we'll meet you soon and we'll update you. And please keep emailing regarding the NMC draft. And me, Dr. Arman, our IFMS MCI Gurukul team, and our Indian Association of Foreign Medical Education Consultant team is always there with you, all of you. We won't let any bad thing happen with you or any injustice happen with you. We'll definitely try to help you in all the things. So bye-bye. Take care. And if you have any query, you have our number, you can get back to us. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Take care. Good night.